Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Snehal and I make videos on fashion, lifestyle and beauty. And today I'm back with another makeup tutorial for you all. Oh my god guys, how many of you have requested for this video? I have already made a beginner friendly makeup video previously on my channel, but that was not that detailed, and this video I have made very detailed, so it is going to be very helpful for you. This is a super long video, so grab yourself some snacks, your water, coffee, anything, and sit back and watch this video till the end. It's going to be very helpful for all of you, and you're going to get to know about the products, the techniques, everything about a beginner should know about a makeup. So stay tuned guys and keep on watching. But before that, you guys know what to do. Subscribe to my channel and hit the like button for this video as well, and I'm going to leave the Instagram handle in the description box down below, so do check that out and do follow me there also. And without any further ado, let's just get started. So let's begin guys. So before starting any makeup, we are going to first moisturize our face. I'm using the Garnier Wrinkle Lift for that. I'm going to just take some and apply it all over my face.
It's very important to moisturize your face before doing makeup.
So wait for 2 minutes, let moisturizer get absorbed by your skin nicely, and then we are going to move on and apply the primer. So for primer, I am using Nykaa's Prep Me Up. It's very very important that you use primer before doing any kind of makeup, even the basic makeup, because then you have texture on your skin or you have large pores, it will blur out all the imperfections in terms of texture. So you just have to take this much amount and put it wherever you have large pores or you know uneven texture, and massage it into your skin like this. Basically your T-zone where you need the primer the most. Primer also helps you know the foundation to glide smoothly on your face, and it makes it look flawless, your base look flawless. So take good amount of time to do this step and massage it like this into your pores. Just don't apply it and leave it like that, just massage it nicely into your pores. Again give 2 minutes time to the primer to settle onto your skin, and after this step you can definitely go ahead and apply the foundation directly. But as I have got some acne spots here, so I am going to conceal them with a concealer. So I am using MAC Studio Fix Concealer. It's a full coverage concealer guys, and you can also use it you know to hide acne spots, like you know spot directly on the spots you can apply like this, and you can also use it as a color corrector because it has a nice orange undertone to it. So you can use it on your under eyes also if you have very dark under eyes. So wherever I have acne spots, I'm just going to apply a little bit of it just in a dabbing motion like this, and I like to apply it on the corner of my eyes. You can totally skip this step if you don't have dark under eyes or acne spots. You can totally skip this step. I like to apply some on my eyelids also to give that even toned look to my eyelids. I'm going to take a damp beauty blender and I'm going to just blend it out. Now we are going to go ahead and apply foundation. For foundation, I'm using the L'Oreal's Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. This is in the shade 108 Caramel Beige. It's an amazing everyday foundation, and it's a full coverage foundation. And with this foundation you don't even need concealer because it is a pretty full coverage foundation. You just need 2 drops of this foundation and you'll be good to go. So I'm just going to take some and dot it all over my face. You can also blend it with your hands like this. You don't even need brush to blend this foundation. So as a beginner, you can blend it with your hands, or you can take a stippling brush like this. This is a brush barrier technique, and you can blend it out like this. And the best part about this foundation is that you don't have to set it with a loose powder, because it immediately dries and gives that finished look to your face. So you don't need a makeup setting powder to set this foundation, because it is not going to come off. If you feel you need more coverage, you can always take some more foundation and apply it. I think I'm happy with this coverage. Take good amount of time to blend your foundation. That's how your base is going to look flawless. Now next I'm going to highlight my under eye area and my high points on the face. So I'm going to use this concealer by LA Girl. It's called LA Girl Pro Conceal, and it's in the shade Pure Beige. So you can definitely skip this step if you don't like highlighted eyes, but I really like that because it gives nice dimension to your face. So I'm just going to take some, directly apply it under my eyes like this. Oops, I applied too much. On my forehead, on the bridge of my nose, on my cupid bows, and on my chin. And I'm going to blend it out using a beauty blender, a damp beauty blender. This gives you a nice bright eyed look. And your eyes also look more open. I am just blending it at its place. I'm not moving it anywhere around. So just blend wherever we have applied. So now we are going to set our concealer using a loose finishing powder. I'm using Maybelline's Fit Me Loose Finishing Powder in the shade medium. It is very important that you set your concealer if you don't want creases under your eyes. So I'm going to take the beauty blender and dip it and take that much of amount and just set my concealer in place. So with that, we are done with our base, and I'm quickly going to do my eyebrows. For that I'm using Miss Claire's pencil, eyebrow pencil, and I'm just going to fill my eyebrows. My eyebrows are all out of the shape because of this lockdown. Oh my god, I badly need to get my eyebrows done. Just bear with me, guys. So I'm just going to fill in. I'm not drawing any extra lines here because they're already all boxy. And basically I'm just defining it. And with the spoolie, I'm just going to groom them and comb them and take any extra product out. So as this is a beginner friendly makeup, I have decided that I'm going to use very less products and show you the look. So it is going to be a very subtle and nice natural look that you can carry every day. So I am going to use this palette by Maybelline. It's their blush, highlight and contour palette. So I am going to use the same thing for blush, highlight and contour obviously, but I am going to use this only as an eyeshadow and create an eye look also. So let's begin with this. So I'm going to take a fluffy eyeshadow brush like this. This is by Pro Arte and the brush number is PE22. So I'm going to take this pink color and put it all over my eyelid. By the way, I have got some kind of pimple or mole, I don't know, over here on my eyes. So just ignore that for this video, guys. So just put it all over your eyelid like this. And blend. Same I'm going to do on the other eye. You see how beautiful it is looking already and so nice and soft look it is creating. Now next I'm going to take this contour shade and I'm going to put it on the outer corner of my eye to give that depth and blend it like this inside.
It's looking beautiful, beautiful it is looking.
So next I'm going to take more pointy brush. This is by again Pro Arte. The brush number is PE23 and I'm going to take this contour shade and apply it under my waterline. And I'm going to take the pink one also and apply it. It's important that you bring some color to your waterline because otherwise it will look very incomplete. Now next I am going to take this highlight shade and I am just going to apply it on my eyeballs. It gives a very nice look. It gives that depth to your eyes. You can see the difference. This eye immediately looks bigger, appear bigger and more open. So I'm just going to do that. You can do it with your fingers. And again I am going to take that fluffy brush and take this contour shade and blend it all together. Just do it in your crease so it creates that crease line for you. See, this is your crease line. I'm just doing it in the crease line. Beautiful it is looking. Now I'm going to take that pointy brush and take the highlight from this palette and put it in the inner corner of my eye. Just dot it like this. And put some highlighter on the arch of your eyebrow also. This whole palette is very beautiful and highly pigmented. I definitely recommend this palette to beginners especially. Next I'm going to take this Kajal, this Kohl by Plum, and I am going to tight line my upper lash line. It's time for my favorite makeup product and it is mascara. This is by the Maybelline. It's called the Falsy Push-Up Drama, and this is a washable one. I definitely recommend washable mascara because it is very easy to remove, because when you use a waterproof mascara, it, you know, strips off your lashes. So I really recommend and suggest that you use a washable mascara. So I'm just going to take some mascara, clean the wand and take the excess product out. And while applying the mascara, just curl your lashes upwards like this. See the difference in both the eyes. This mascara is beautiful.
It immediately gives you that, you know, dramatic eye look. It's a very beautiful mascara.
If you want a heavier mascara, more dramatic mascara, you can just let the one coat of mascara dry and then you can apply the mascara again. I then like apply one more coat on the mascara. I just love applying mascara. It's my most favorite makeup product. Now we are going to do the blush, highlight and contour. So I am using the same palette again and I am going to take a fluffy brush like this and just dab it. Don't drag the blush on your face ever. Just dab it like this. And you have to take it upwards. I like to put some on my nose as well. It's a very nice fresh pink color. It gives you that dewy finish. So this is basically a bronzer. I don't like harsh contour lines on my face. I like to bronze up my face. So I'm going to take this brush. This is a random brush. I don't know from where I got this. So I'm going to take this shade and, you know, in circular motion like this, I am going to create that bronzing effect where you have your hollow space. You have to apply your bronzer there. And you have to connect your blush and contour or bronzer together so it looks all connected. Some on your forehead. So basically you have to create a shape of three like this. Some on your jawline also you have to apply. Do it with a very, very light hand. You're basically creating a shadow effect and giving dimensions to your face to achieve that, you know, like sharp, chiseled look. You see that the cut, that shadow effect going on my face. Basically when we apply foundation, our face looks flat. So with this, we create a shadow effect and dimensions we give to our face. Now I'm going to take this flat side of the brush and create a shape on my nose as well. You see those lines? And if you have a more pointy nose like me, you can just put some bronzer here so it creates that shadow effects and it, your nose looks a little shorter. Now time for the highlighter. So I am going to use the same highlighter with a fan brush like this, and I'm just going to put it on the apple of my cheeks and like this on my forehead as well. So it is all this portion that you put highlighter. It's a very nice subtle highlighter for everyday use. It's not that blinding, but obviously it is buildable, so you can build it up to blinding highlighter, but just one stroke and you have that glow on your face, you know, like a very subtle glow. So this is a very nice daily use highlighter. Some on the bridge of your nose and forehead and your cupid bows. You see the glow? Makeup, just the lipstick is left, but before that I am going to set my makeup with a makeup fixing spray, so all my makeup is melted and you know it is all one soul. So I am just going to, I am taking MAC Prep and Prime makeup fixer, so I'm just going to spritz some on my face. And lastly the lipstick. I'm using Maybelline's Sensational Liquid Matte Lipstick in the shade Best Babe. I love this shade. This is such an amazing nude shade for the dusky skin tone like me. Definitely give this a try guys. This is just for 349 rupees and totally worth it. The formula is so good. I mean it feels very comfortable on the lips and it immediately dries out. So as in like it dries but it doesn't make your lips dry and it is very very moisturizing, gives a very nice finish. I really like this one. I am going to mix L'Oreal's 105 eye rule shade also in this. This is also another gorgeous shade. I just love mixing these two lipsticks. It's that perfect nude mauve kind of a shade and I love that shade.
So this is the final look guys. I hope you liked watching this video and this video of mine helped you. Do let me know in the comments down below and don't forget to subscribe to my channel guys and hit the like button for this video as well. And I'm going to see you in my next one. Bye.